This morning we are joined by the multi-talented Rita Ora. How are you?
How are you?
I'm good, I'm good. You've been busy.
Thank you. Yes, I'm very lucky. I am actually really blessed. I mean, it's amazing to keep working. So yeah, I'm very happy that we're here to talk about some stuff.
Yeah, and obviously we're all watching you right now on The Masked Singer every week, which I love.
Oh yeah. That's so fun.
But you're also in the new Sky original film Twist. So tell me about that.
Yes, Twist. Well, it's a modern twist of Oliver Twist, which is really great. I mean, a Charles Dickens classic. We really wanted to do a script, I think, you know, all the director and the producer, just to give a modern approach to something that's so iconic, and especially it being British and filming it in London and it having that heritage. I was really eager to be a part of it. And the cast was just really amazing. It really blew me away from new amazing upcoming acts to legends, you know. So it was just such a great variety of actors that I was like, I have to be involved. So when it came and it landed in my lap, and I just thought, wow, I'd love to really adapt to this character. And actually, what really made me want to do it is Artful Dodger, who for me was my favorite character in the thing growing up, because he's just super cheeky. And to do my twist on it for me was amazing. I really wanted to put my spin on it.
Yeah, so like you said, Twist is a twist on the original Oliver Twist.
Yeah, exactly.
Did you feel pressure like trying to rework a classic? Because like you said, I mean, we've all seen it. We've seen so many adaptations.
Yeah, I actually, you know, it wasn't bad pressure. It was more just like exciting, a challenge of a pressure, because everybody had their same aim on that was involved in the movie. And I think that this would be what Charles Dickens would have probably have done if, you know, in, I was, what, 1839, or when Oliver Twist came out for the first time, it was his interpretation of street slang and the life on the streets. And I think for us now, shooting it in this time, it's our interpretation of the life and the life on the streets. So I really love that I was a part of that sort of progression. And again, Artful Dodger was originally a guy, so to be able to do something so modern and put a flip on it was something that, knowing me, I love a challenge. I was like, let's do it. And I'm really happy we did. Yeah.
Yeah, I was going to actually ask you about that, because obviously traditionally Artful Dodger has been played by a male every time. That's how it's written. So can you see yourself doing any other male roles, like maybe like a James Bond female?
I mean, who knows? I think what's so cool about our day and age and us growing up in this society now is that things are progressing. You know, it's better late than never. And I feel like not just with movies, just in life in general, and for women and men and the gender roles, I don't really think that's as much of a priority as I think it used to be. And I really love that about the time that we live in, and I'm always going to champion that. So I think it's fantastic.
Yeah, I love that. Is there any other classic film that you'd like to see a modern version of?
Oh yeah, so many. First of all, I'd love to see they've already done the Jungle Book, haven't they?
Yeah.
Already done, because I loved that one growing up. Stuart Little maybe would be fun.
Yeah.
Not old enough, maybe.
Maybe, but you know, we're here for it. You know, we need some new content right now.
Isn't that like 2001?
It's fine. It's been 10 years. So it's been 20 years. So what was it like playing Dodge and like watching yourself playing such a hard character, like being a gang leader?
It was everything. It was everything. And it was almost like my alter ego, you know, my inner ego. You know, I grew up in West London. I grew up in a middle-class family. I grew up in a council estate. You know, it was definitely something that I was familiar with in that sense. So it wasn't crazy. It was just actually fun, because I got to be kind of more like, you know, gangster with it all. And it was really cool to be able to like boss people around a little bit.
Yeah, it's funny. There's so much action in it. Like you're running away from the police, you're in a pub. Like, did you have to have any training to do any like the fight scenes or anything?
Yeah, there was stunts on set, professionals. But to be fair, I tried to do my own as much as possible. But to be honest, Raff Law did a lot of his own stunts. Wow. And I'm so impressed. All the backflipping and the jumping off stairs and all this. I mean, that really was Raff a lot of the time. So I was taking some notes. But at the same time, I was like, jump over this wall rather than backflip over the wall.
Yeah, exactly.
If I could learn, I would definitely do it. You know, I definitely would love to learn. It would be amazing.
Yeah, I mean, you got to play a police officer at one point. You were in disguise, and you always experiment with your fashion looks. Like, you take a lot of risks. Like, is there any disguise or any outfit that you'd like to try that you haven't done yet?
I think for me, I've done a few fun, crazy looks. I think I would just love to keep experimenting with characters. I think why I love doing film now so much as music is that I genuinely can get absorbed into the character and not have to explain why I look the way I look.
Yeah.
I always have been like that with fashion. I've never really explained why I dress how I dress. I always just love dressing the way I dress. And maybe that just comes from my mum. You know, she's always super encouraging in like being yourself and wearing what you want. So I was very lucky growing up.
Yeah, and we've seen you act before, obviously, in many different things, like 50 Shades, Southpaw, but you could really come into your own in this film. Yes. Like, what was it like doing this compared to the roles you played before?
It was the best. First shooting in London, I felt super comfortable, super safe, kind of, you know, you go home every day after work.
Yeah.
It was amazing playing in a British accent, having the ability to, like, exaggerate the accent like that and just sort of, like, going with the flow. And I just really enjoyed it, you know, I really did. And Sir Michael Caine's Cockney classes were fantastic.
What, he gave you lessons?
I obviously had a million things to ask him because he's just the best. And I'm such a fan of his. So there was everything about blowing the bloody doors off. How did that actually happen? To, you know, what is your process? To how do you learn all these lines? You know, there were so many things. I think at one point he was like, okay, now, can you just stop? No, he never did that. He was super supportive and helpful. But yeah, I mean, he's just so iconic. I was really obsessed, actually. I was just like watching him like, oh. Yeah,
like teach me the ways, teach you. It's an amazing masterclass. That's cool. So you're smashing your music career, fashion, TV, now acting. Is there anything else you want to try and conquer?
Well, of course, I just would love to keep going. You know, I think I have always grown up with women like Cher and everything that, for people that don't just do one thing. And I just loved that about artists in general. You know, you get to put your creativity in so many different aspects and challenge yourself. So I think if I'm challenging myself, then I'm doing the right thing.
Yes. And the music in Twist was so good as well. Like, can we expect any new music from you this year?
Definitely. Of course. See, now that never stops flowing. You know, that ball will always keep rolling.
Yeah, that's your number one passion. I love that.